This is a multiplayer session between Herman Hum and Alexandre H. We've chosen the Shark's Teeth scenario from the Sea of Dragons battle set. Alexandre will command the Republic of Korea forces, and I am commanding the Democratic People's Republican forces. My mission will examine the scenario background information and see that this scenario is 24 hours in duration. My orders are for the successful infiltration of submarine into a landing zone near Kangnung. A Romeo class submarine has been assigned to escort and harass enemy shipping. This is my mission, to get the midget submarine within 10 miles of the reference point. All other considerations are secondary. I am authorized to attack shipping as a last resort. Here is my Romeo class diesel electric submarine and my midget. This is my destination, Liberation Zone. I'll turn over the controls to Alexander. These are his forces.
Okay, so I've got an escort group and a group of landing ships, and I must take them to Kansong port. So I plan to move along the coast toward Kansong.
Take control of the mouse if you like.
I cannot. No.
Okay, that's your escort group.
Yeah.
Transports.
No, the control is not flawless.
That's from numpad. Those are the transports. Okay.
Yes.
We'll start. This is Kansong. So you're going to move. Oh, that's interesting. You're going to move to the coast before moving across.
Yeah, because I want my transport and my escort group to join together in order to offer better protection to the
Let's see what your escorts are. You have the Pohang corvette and a guided missile destroyer. Guided missile frigate. Oh, a very powerful. I thought you had two frigates. My mistake. From my perspective, I ordered my Romeo to scout ahead of the midget submarine. The midget submarine has very, very, very limited endurance. As we can see, it's only about 30 minutes, and it runs very, very slowly. So it moves only one or two knots. It's quiet and it's small, but it's almost constantly recharging her batteries. I've ordered her to head towards in the fastest possible route. Lots of unknown contacts. Judging by the speed, and this one's been identified as a Dow, there seems to be lots of commercial fishery in the area. Here's my first contact of an enemy vessel. He's moving at 29 knots. This is typical of the Perry class frigates, and he's confirmed moving at high speed. This is just from experience rather than classification. The AI is unable to classify him, but I know he's hostile and he's probably a frigate, just judging by his maximum speed here. A second vessel is doing 29 knots. I thought this was a second frigate at 29, but it turns out it must be the corvette Bohang. Did you detect me yet? Did you detect anything?
No. No, no,
here,
I had no
he's
idea.
He's dropping a sonar buoy. I have to be careful because sonar buoys and helicopters are my worst enemy. But I have a pretty good track on him. He's moving fairly quickly, so I can see where he's going. Unfortunately, he's going to be cutting me right across. So I start moving towards the port and try to lend support for my midget submarine. Still lots of activity around me, but this is neutral. It seems to be harmless fishermen. He slowed down and he seems to be patrolling this area, which is right where I happen to be wanting to go. That's not a good thing. A few more contacts have materialized. One at this range has been classified as a landing ship medium, and we know it's, well, it says Greece, but we know this is the same one operated by the Korean Navy. He's moving at 9 knots, and there are two more. I'm estimating these are probably escorts, moving since they're moving a little bit faster than the merchant fishing dhows. Still, they do pose a threat as my midget submarine attempts to make her ingress. These are cutting right across her path. I would prefer not to fire upon them and follow my orders, but I do have clearance to engage if I feel the need to do so. Have you seen anything at this point?
No.
Okay.
Maybe bingo fuel, you know, maybe that to go back to resupply.
I can see a formation of four, and I believe that they're all the same because they're moving the same speed. So this is likely a transport or amphibious group. I've decided to move in and attack. I believe I've gotten myself behind the screen. It appears to be this is the screen, and I have managed to sneak in behind it. I was hoping to engage at least three of them, and so I let them close and until I could get three of them within range at the same time. The AI will not let me fire, even though this is within the theoretical torpedo range. The AI does not allow me to fire until it thinks that it cannot escape the torpedo, so there is a no escape envelope. Unfortunately, these two were starting to gain distance, gain separation from my submarine, so I elected to attack just two of them and keep trying to attack the third. Did you see me at this point? There it is.
No. Oh yeah, finally, with the helicopter. And with the helicopter start to attack.
But your ships continued moving in the same direction. You did not think about trying for evasive maneuver?
No. No, I didn't try any evasive maneuvers.
I kept trying to engage the third vessel, so I increased speed in hopes of getting into firing range. The enemy has fired two lightweight Mod 5 near-tip torpedoes, Mark 46. And it appears, no, there's his helicopter. I fired three torpedoes at each contact. Unfortunately, these torpedoes have picked up contacts a long distance and are totally ignoring their intended target. I have no wire control over these or wire guidance to these torpedoes, so I can't tell them to, or I can't help them find the target. Had I known that they were chasing these distant targets, I might have fired another batch, another wave, but I kept wanting to engage this one down here. My submarine is sunk, but the torpedoes continue onwards. Here's a Mark 46 still hunting for me, but my torpedoes are still heading outwards. Did we sink one? There we did. We did, right there. One of your escorts was sunk.
No.
That's the...
I had it up.
That goes... That's the... What is that? Pohang? And the torpedoes.
Yeah,
oh, I've actually managed to catch this boat, get this far, and it missed. Notice how the submarine, the Goblin, still appears here, because you were unable to hear the actual torpedo hit it and or hear the submarine sink, that the contact does not disappear from your screen. So you don't know that you've sunk it, and there could still, you don't know if there's still a submarine alive in this area. This is one of the good things about Harpoon.
Yeah, so I keep on looking for it, and I keep on shooting at the submarine. I'm sure that the submarine is still around and may still attack, so I send everything I have over it.
Exactly, yeah. But that's the wonderful thing about this game, is that if you don't know, then it continues to draw more attention and more of your resources, because you're prosecuting something that's already dead, but you didn't hear it. So that's I really enjoy this part of the game.
So yes.
Let's go. Yeah, look at all those torpedoes you're firing at it. Wow. And finally, you lost contact with it. So either you sank it or you just lost contact.
Yeah, I want to get it.
You did arrive
and
safely.
And then I keep on, northward towards
meanwhile,
the port of Kansong.
My midget submarine was creeping in towards her destination. Moving at only one knot is really slow. So while the enemy was clustered around his port, I snuck in behind him. Alex thought he had won because he had gotten his three ships or his transports to the port as ordered. However, he had sustained a loss because I had sank one of his escorts. He could not fulfill his victory condition. Upon arrival, my submarine, midget submarine, arrived within her destination and fulfilled my victory conditions, and I was granted victory at this time. Anything else to add?
Well, it seems I have
Would you
lost
have done anything
because one of my
differently now
boats
that
was
you've
sunk.
seen how it plays out?
Because in my victory conditions, I could not lose any boat. Maybe try to get my escort closer to the transport, but it's pretty hard to manage the submarines. You know, because Evan, I know where it is.
Why didn't you drop
Evan,
more
I shot
sonar
at it.
buoys when you were
I don't know
prosecuting
whether
the
it has been,
submarine?
whether it is sinking or alive.
Ah,
I
okay.
was
So because you didn't
launching
hear it the first time,
plenty
the
of
first
sonar
time it
buoys
was hit,
around, and
you kept
but
dropping more.
it seems it was alive.
Good fight. That was very close. You almost got this one, and you almost got. Had you,
Yeah,
if you
Captain.
had not lost your escort, you would have arrived and you would have won the scenario before me. But the important, a good thing to learn from this is the orders are the only important thing. My orders were to get here. It does not matter how many I sink or whether or not the Romeo submarine was lost. The only thing that mattered was for my midget submarine to arrive and deliver her troops. Same with your orders. It doesn't matter. Well, you could sink both of them or get your transports to the port. Anything else to add?